Hi students, welcome to English class. We'll continue with Act 3, Scene 4. In the previous class, we have seen how Lorenzo was praising Portia and Portia seeking the help of Lorenzo, asking whether he would look after her household when she moves with Portia to the monastery. With Nerissa to the monastery. So over here, we find Portia devising a clever plan to save Antonio's life. Lorenzo. Madam, with all my heart, I shall obey you in all fair commands. So in the previous scene, we have seen Portia asking Lorenzo or requesting Lorenzo to look after her household till she as well as Nerissa returns. So the reply given by Lorenzo is, Madam, with all my heart, I shall obey you in all fair commands. So Lorenzo is chilling. Of course, madam, with all my heart, I shall obey you in all fair commands. I will obey you in all the fair commands. Whatever you say, I am willing to obey. Portia, my people already know my mind and will acknowledge you and Jessica in place of Lord Bassanio and myself. And so farewell till we shall meet again. So Portia is chilling. My people here stands for my servants, do already know my mind. They know my intention. They know what is my intention. And will acknowledge you. And therefore, they will acknowledge, meaning they will recognize you. And Jessica, they will recognize both you as well as Jessica. That is Lorenzo and Jessica. In place of Lord Bassanio and myself. So she is chilling. Already, she might have informed the matter to her servants. So she is telling, my people already know my mind. They know me. What is my intention? So they will recognize you and Jessica in place of Lord Bassanio and myself. And so, farewell. And so, goodbye. Till we shall meet again. Till they meet again. So Lorenzo, fair thoughts and happy hearts attend on you. So Lorenzo is wishing. So now both Portia as well as Nerissa is planning to move to the monastery as what she informed Lorenzo. So hearing this, Lorenzo is sharing fair thoughts. Let fair thoughts. Fair thought means let good thoughts. And happy hearts. And let you pass your time happily attend on you. Let only good things happen to you. Jessica, I wish your ladyship all hearts content. So now Jessica is wishing. Jessica is telling, I wish your ladyship. I wish you, madam, all hearts content. All the hearts content. Whatever is your desire in your heart, let it be fulfilled. Portia, I thank you for your wish. And I'm well pleased to wish it back on you. Fare you well, Jessica. So Portia is chilling. I thank you for your wish. She is thanking her back. I thank you for your wish. And I am well pleased to wish it back on you. And also she is wishing the same to Jessica. Wish you the same. Fare you well, Jessica. So she is bidding goodbye to Jessica. Exeunt Jessica and Lorenzo. So after bidding goodbye to Portia, Lorenzo and Jessica clears the scene. Exeunt Jessica and Lorenzo. So now, whom we can find with her is Balthazar. So let's see what Portia is telling to Balthazar. Who is Balthazar? Balthazar is one of the trusted servant of Portia. So what Portia is telling to Balthazar is, now Balthazar, as I have ever found the honest true, so let me find this shell. Take this same letter and use thou all the endeavor of man in speed to Padua. See thou, render this into my cousin's hand, Dr. Bellario. So she is telling to Balthazar. Now Balthazar, as I have ever found the honest true, I have always found you honest and a very truthful person. You have always been honest and very truthful to me. Till now you were very honest and truthful to me. So let me find this shell. So I hope that you will continue to to be the same to me. You will continue to be the same to me. Take the same letter. So she is giving one letter to Balthazar. Use thou all endeavor of a man. Meaning, go as fast as a man can do. Go as fast as man can do in speed to Padua. In speed to Padua. He is supposed to go to Padua. See, thou render this into my cousin's hand, Dr. Bellario. And once you reach Padua, you are supposed to render this. You are supposed to give this. Render means give this. To my cousin's hand, Dr. Bellario. So, who is Dr. Bellario? Dr. Bellario is the cousin of Portia. You have to give it to my cousin's hand. And look, what notes and garments he doth give thee. And look, what notes and garments. Notes here stands for documents. And see, what are the documents and garments. Garments means costumes, which he give to you. Bring them, I pray thee. So she's telling, bring them, I pray thee. I request you to bring them to me. Bring them, I pray thee, with imagined speed. I request you to bring them to me. With imagined speed. Imagined speed means with all the conceivable speed. With the maximum speed you can. The utmost speed you can. And where you have to bring it is to the Tranect. Unto the Tranect. Tranect means the landing place where the fairies comes. Landing place. Of the ferries unto the Tranect, to the common ferry which trades to Venice. So you have to bring it to the landing place where the ferries goes to, heads to Venice. That is, I'll be near the shore. You have to be there and near the Tranect, and you have to give these documents and costumes to me. The Tranect. Waste no time in words. And again she's chilling. So Balthazar, don't waste any more time. But get thee gone. Please go soon. I shall be there before thee. Before you reach there, I'll be over there. So let's see what's the reply given by Balthazar. Balthazar, madam, I go with all convenience fee. So, Balthazar is telling, madam, as you said, I'll go with all convenient speed. I'll go with the maximum speed possible for me. Exit. So, saying so, Balthazar exit from the scene. Now, Portia. Come on, Mirza. I have work in hand that you yet know not of. We'll see our husbands, but they think of us. Before they think of us. So Portia is chilling. Come on, Nerissa. I have work in hand. I have work in hand means I have a plan in my mind. That you yet know not of. That you are not aware of till now. We'll see our husbands. So, Portia is chilling. We are going to meet our husbands. Before they think of us. Before they can expect to see us. Before they expect to see us. That is, before they could think of us. Or before they are expecting. Or before they wish to see us. We will be there at our husband's side. So, Nerissa. Shall they see us? So Nerissa is asking, if it is so, will our husbands identify us? Portia is chilling. They shall, Nerissa, but in such a habit that they shall think we are. So Portia is chilling, of course. They shall, they will also find us. But in such a habit. But when they find us, we will be in such a habit. Such a habit means our costume will be in such a disguise. It won't be in our ordinary costume. We will be in some other pattern. We will be in disguise. That they shall think we are. That they shall think we are accomplished with what we lack. So they will think that we are accomplished, meaning we are equipped with what we lack, with those qualities which we do not have. That is, here Portia is planning to disguise themselves as two gentlemen, two young men. That is why she is telling that when our husbands finds us, they will find that we are accomplished. We are equipped with what we lack. We are equipped with those qualities of men which we lack in reality. When they find us, we will be in disguise. So they will think that we are having those qualities which we really lack in our life. When they find us, we will be in gents costume. So they will think that we are having those qualities of men which in reality we lack. I'll hold thee any wager. When we are both accorded like young men, I'll prove prettier fellow of the two. So again she is telling, she is in a very good mood then. So she is telling, I'll hold thee any wager, meaning I'll bet you for any amount. When we are both accoutred means dressed up like young men. When we are both dressed up like young men, I'll prove the prettier fellow of the two. I'll be more smarter than you. I'll be more smarter than you. And wear my dagger with a braver grace. And I'll catch my dagger with greater air of boldness. Wear my dagger with a braver grace. Braver grace means more gallantly or with more power. And speak between the change of man and boy. So what I'm planning to do is that once we are dressed up like two young men, I will be more handsome than you. That is first condition. Secondly, I'll be carrying dagger with a braver grace. I'll catch my dagger in a very gallant manner, like a chivalrous soldier, and speak between the change of man and boy. And then, what is going to be my voice? I'm a girl now. So I'll speak in a shrill voice, like the voice which is changing from a boy's voice to a man's voice, as if my voice is changing from a boy's voice to a man's voice, between the change of man and boy. That is like a young teenager whose voice has got that shrillness between the man's voice and the young boy's, with a reed voice. And usually teenager's voice has got a different sound. It will be a reed voice. Reed voice means shrill voice. And turn two mincing steps. And now, being a girl, I walk with two mincing steps. Mincing steps means we walk like a lady-like, with short, quick steps. Now, since I'm going to be a boy, what I'm planning to do is, I'll turn this usual two mincing steps, that is lady-like walk, into a manly stride. I'll change my style of walking also. Instead of taking short lady-like steps, I'll walk very fast, just like a manly stride. That is, usually, when the ladies take two steps, men cover the same distance with one step. So instead of walking like with two mincing steps of ladies, once I am dressed up like a boy, I will walk with a manly stride, or I'll walk like a gentleman itself. So till now what she said is that once she is dressed up like a man, she will be more handsome than Nerissa. She will hold a dagger in a very gallant manner, and her voice will be a voice between the changing voice between a man and a voice, like a young teenager's voice with much shrillness. And she will change her usual lady-like steps into a manly stride. Not only that, and speak a phrase like a fine bragging youth. And moreover, I'll be always speaking of phrase. Phrase means I will always be speaking about fights. Like a fine bragging youth. Like a boastful youth. Usually youths, whenever they get a company, they will try to upgrade themselves. Or they will try to glorify themselves by speaking or by telling lies about some of the great fights which they have got in fold. Maybe that is all lies. But in order to boast themselves, they keep on saying about some of the great fights which they have taken part. And tell quaint lies. And likewise, I'll continue saying quaint lies. Quaint lies means fanciful lies. How honorable ladies sought my love. So some of the fanciful lies which I am going to say is how some of the honorable ladies, how some of the respectable ladies sought my love. Sought my love here means how some of the respectable ladies came behind me asking me to love them. Sought my love, how much they were behind me wanting me to love them. Sought my love means wanting me to love them. Which I denying, but I, being a very handsome and a bold boy, denied it. So that is the lies which he is going to say. But I, on denying it, they fell sick. So he simply denied it. And because he denied his love to those respectable ladies, they fell sick. They became sick. And died. I could not do with all. Then I'll repent. So he's telling. And that is, he denied his love to some respectable ladies. So they were much discouraged. They fell sick and died. And also he will be boasting. Saying that I could not do with all. I could not do with all. Meaning I could not help it. So he will be simply boasting and simply boasting. And saying that what could I do there? I could not simply love them. I could not say yes to them. So I denied it. I could not do with all. I could not help it. I cannot do anything other than saying no to them. Then I'll repent. And finally, he will be repenting. He will be regretting. Repent means regret. And wish for all that I had not killed them. So, what are the boastful things that he is going to tell to others is that how many respectable ladies were behind him, asking him to, begging him to love him, and he would deny and since he had denied love to them, they fell sick and they die. And again, he will be boasting and saying that actually I could not do anything other than that. And he regret for killing all those ladies by denying his love to them. And he will be regretting. He will be sitting and regretting there, saying that, oh, simply because I've denied my love to them, they have died. And saying that, I should not have killed them by denying my love to them. And 20 of these puny lies I'll tell. So he's telling, once I'm dressed up like a young man, 20 such puny lies I'll tell. I'll keep on saying such 20 such puny lies. Puny lies here stands for such credible lies. That man shall swear, I have discontinued school about a 12 month. So I'll keep on saying 20 such puny lies or credible lies. That men shall swear and it will make others believe, or men shall say to others, they will believe that I have discontinued schools about a 12 month. That it is only a year since I have discontinued my school. That I am a young teenager. That others will have a feeling that I am a very young teenager. Or a young man who has discontinued school only 1 year ago. I have within my mind 1,000 raw tricks of these bragging jacks. So he is telling. Likewise, I have in my mind 1,000 raw tricks of these bragging jacks. So he's telling, likewise, I've got a number of 1,000 raw tricks. Raw tricks means crude tricks. or boyish tricks of these bragging jacks, meaning boastful fellows. I'll act like a boastful boy once I am dressed up like a young man, which I will practice. And I will put all those 1,000 tricks which I have got in my mind into practice once I am dressed like a young man. But come, I'll tell the whole device when I am in my couch. When I am in my coach, which says for us at the park gate. So Porsche is chilling. But come now, I don't have time to describe all my bragging tricks to you. But come, you join with me. I'll tell you. These stands for Nereza. I'll tell you all my whole device, my entire plans. Whole device stands for my entire plans. When I am in my coach, the coach is waiting near the gate. So once we are in the coach, I'll tell you all my plans, which stays for us. The coach is staying or waiting for us at the park gate. It is waiting near the park gate. And therefore, haste away. And therefore, be quick. For we must measure 20 miles today. For we have to cover 20 miles. We have to travel. We must measure means we must travel 20 miles today. Because we have to move to the place, that is Venice, very quickly. We have to cover at least 20 miles today. So come on, let's move away from here very quickly. So with this, we have come to the end of Act 3, Scene 4. In the next class, we'll begin with Act 3, Scene 5.